we'll take another four drop here. If this wasn't in the pack, we would gladly take Prophetic Prism, but McKinney Griffin's a good man. And Nofgaard Hound's fine as well. Playing with a couple cards never played with before. Never played with the Student of Warfare. Never played with the Core Spirit Dancer. Yeah, I actually don't know which of those. Like, the Fire, the Knight of Cliffhaven is going to be a... Ooh, we did table. That's awesome. Fireware thing. My apologies. I did not foresee it. Snake Umbra is a pretty good card to table here. Naturalize is also good, but we already have the Spirit Dancer and a couple more Flyers, so Snake Umbra is a solid card. And there's the Totem Guide Harpies for us, which is good with... We already have three auras. Praise Vengeance fine, as is the Guard Hound. We already picked up one Guard Hound, so... I guess the second Guard Hound's probably better than the first. But that's fine. Anyway, yeah, Knight of Cliffhaven being a Flyer and all is good with our auras. But this guy just seems like he's blatantly more powerful. He's harder to get active since he doesn't require... Since he requires white mana, but... we could play with another card I've never played with this time, but I'm going to take it, but I don't think I'm going to play with it. Our deck seems a little too aggressive. Snake Umber, Boar Umber, and Hyena Umber so far. Maybe we'll open up a Eldrazi Conscription. One can hope. We open up a Deathless Angel, so I guess... She's so fat. Fatty McAngel. Maybe we'll table Bramble Snap. I think it'd be this pack. No, we already... Yeah, it would have been like this pack. Not playing any of this. Take a rare. When in doubt, gank a rare. Take an Ela number. Unified Will should probably not be that... I love a Unified Will. People don't seem to have the respect for it that I do. Alright. That got way better, that pack. Got some sweet rares. And there's another sweet rare. I mean, that's a good card to accelerate into, I suppose. There's also a Dongar Invoker and a Gross Spasm and an Artisan and etc., etc. But I think a Gelatinous Genesis is going to be the best out of all of those. Feel free. I mean, Artisan's also very good, but I think Gelatinous Genesis is better in this style deck since you're presenting multiple threats at the same time, and we're already going to have other threats out, so I'm going to roll with it. Open up some pretty good cards. There's an Ornarlid that we're definitely wanting. I wanted Oust too, but I'm not going to take it over Ornarlid, which goes perfect in our deck. So yeah. We're at 20 playables. Currently have no removal. That's fine. We're just super aggro. We have a Flame Slash that is still not making the cut. I would like at least one more 2-drop. Preferably something like a Nest Invader or a Bramble Snap. Something like that. Or another Core Spirit Dancer. Alright, that's probably getting a little too greedy. This deck looks pretty sweet, though. There's a Dawn Glare Invoker, so I'll take that. I'm going to pass up on the Gross Spasm. I don't think the Flame Slash is making the deck, so I'm not going to go out of my way to make it work when there's a solid white card in the pack. Let's see. Guard Duty or Overgrown Battlement. Guard Duty would be nice to have, but I think another Battlement is more important right now to what we want to do. Having another 2-drop is big. Having another 2-drop that accelerates is even bigger. So, yeah, I think I'm going to take the Overgrown Battlement. Hopefully we can pick up a Guard Duty. I would definitely like one. Just to grab with Totem Guide Harpies, Trigger, Core Spirit Dancer, etc. And if we can't get a Guard Duty, any Aura will be fine. Nothing in this pack for us, so we'll take a Sideboard Leaf Arrow. Once again, there is nothing in this pack for us either. None of these cards are really that bad, good against us, so we'll take a Gravity Well. We got two picks to pick up a Guard Duty or something like that. We have a Snake Umber, I think, pack one, so it'd be good to get back. What else is there? Definitely, so Guard Duty or an Umbra, I think, are the two main cards we're looking for. Otherwise, we'll take something like a Nest Invader or another Heart Beast or Emergence Scathe is a good one. I think it's better than Smite. Saves your guy and lets you get through with him the next turn. Alright, so we did not get one of the ores we wanted. Luminous Wake might be playable in this deck, I'm not sure. Probably gonna be better than the Spider, so we just passed multiple Sky Scouts. It's kind of crazy. Take a sideboard to mystify. This is definitely a 17 land deck to have multiple battlements and Jiraga Tree Speakers and Kozilek Predators to get to these. So I'm not worried about our mana too much. Come on, Snake Umbra. I will cut a Luminous Wake in a heartbeat. I really don't want to play this card, but it seems like it has some good value in our deck. Whenever it attacks or blocks. Not sure how many ores need to make this chick good. Currently we're at 4, which would probably be enough. If I had to cut the Luminous Wake, then I don't think we'd have enough, though. I'm still going to play her no matter what, just to get a feel for her. But yeah. Still curious about that versus the Bramble Snap pick. If it was pack 3, I think I'd take Bramble Snap, since I'm not going to have as much time to get the ores. But in pack 2, with a full pack ahead of me and pack 3, I figured I could get enough auras. I really didn't, and that didn't end up being the case, but... this pack's still quite good. I'm just gonna gank a Prophetic Prism. We're not playing the Flame Slash, so I'm not gonna use it, but I think that card is probably gonna be make somebody the happiest if they get it that late. There's a Repel the Darkness, which is a solid card in this style deck. I don't know what I would want to cut for it. I think I want to play the Luminous Wake. Yeah, I don't really have anything I'd want to cut for the Repel the Darkness. So it might sit on the sidelines. I'll bring it in if we face like an aggro matchup or something where it would swing in our favor. But I'm going to try to main deck this Luminous Wake and give it a shot. Also, I've never played with this card. It's just the deck of firsts for me. Alright, and on to deck building. You are in. I guess I have multiple Elan numbers we could run, but they seem worse than a Luminous Wake, I think. There's 23... like that card are the most likely candidate to make the deck. I guess it comes down to whether Elo Number is better than Luminous Wake or not. Luminous Wake seems more like a guard duty that could fetch up with the Totem Guide Heartbeast, whereas Elo Number just seems like it fills, well, no role whatsoever. So I'm just going to stick with the Luminous Wake, see how it goes. And let's add some lands to this bad boy. 8 and 9. That's weird. All of our early, I guess we have more. I'm gonna go the opposite still. We have turn 1 Tree Speaker, turn 2 Battlement that we really won't get online. And really the only card we have to get early out of white is Student of Warfare, and we don't even have to get that early. So I think I'm gonna go 9-8. And we will be back for round 1.